Hello everyone, I am Mr. Sachin Rathod, working as an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from Walchand of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to deal with velocity in mechanism. So today's session outcome is, at the end of this session student will able to understand the relative velocity method. So first of all, you can think about, so where is the necessity to find out the velocity, or in which case the we have to find out the velocity. So you can think about this, why we are finding the velocity. Okay, I will explain you. Suppose if you consider the slider crank mechanism, in that case we are giving input to the shaft. So from the shaft we are knowing the angular velocity of the crank. So we have to find out the velocity of slider. At that time we can use this relative velocity method for finding the velocity of slider, as well as we can find out the angular velocity of connecting rod. Okay, so we will see some basic concept used in relative velocity method. So now we are going to see the basic terms used in relative velocity method. So first one is a linear displacement. It is denoted by letter S. So suppose one body is moving with respect to another fixed point, then it is called as a linear displacement. Suppose this one is a fixed body A. So another body is moving with respect to the A. It is moving up to the B distance. So it is called as a linear displacement, and it is denoted by the letter S. Next one, linear velocity. It is denoted by the letter V. It is nothing but the rate of change of linear displacement with respect to time. It is given by ds by dt. Next one, linear acceleration. It is nothing but it is a rate of change of linear velocity with respect to time. It is denoted by the letter A, is equal to dv by dt. Next, angular displacement. Suppose OB is one line and it travel a angle of delta theta with short interval of the time, then delta theta is the angle taken to take the new position, that is a OB to OC. So this delta theta is called as a angular displacement. Angular velocity, it is a rate of change of angular displacement with respect to time. It is denoted by the letter omega, is equal to d theta by dt. Next, angular acceleration. It is a rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time. It is denoted by the letter alpha, is equal to d omega by dt. So, next one. Now we have to get the concept of relative velocity. So what is meant by relative velocity? Suppose if you consider two bodies are moving in parallel direction. Suppose this is a body having the velocity of A, that is nothing but the VA, and this is a body B having the velocity VB, in which VA is greater than VB, and both are moving in parallel direction. So this is a O point, it's called as a pole, in which now we are knowing the magnitude as well as the direction of the A point. So we are getting the A point here. It will give velocity of A, VA, and we are knowing that the VB in magnitude as well as the in the direction, this will give the velocity of B. So we can easily find out the BA vector is nothing but, this is a BA vector is nothing but OA minus OB. So it will give the relative velocity of A with respect to B is equal to velocity of A minus velocity of B. This is in case of if the two bodies are moving in parallel. If suppose two bodies are moving in inclined direction, suppose this is a body having the velocity of VA and this is a B body having the velocity of VB. We are knowing the magnitude as well as in direction. So this is a O pole from which we have to take the other velocity. So this is your the velocity A we are knowing in magnitude as well as in the direction, and this will give the velocity of B in magnitude as well as in the direction. So if I join A to B, it will give velocity of A with respect to B. So it is a vector quantity. If suppose I have drawn the arrow in the downward direction, it will give velocity of B with respect to A. So this is a concept, basic concept of relative velocity method. Next, the concept of motion of a link. Suppose if you consider one rigid body, this is a rigid body. In that rigid body, if you consider one link, that is a AB link, which is having the rotated in a clockwise direction with angular velocity omega. So in that body, so how the motion of the link will occurs? It is rotated in the clockwise direction with angular velocity omega. Suppose one body is there, suppose this is a OA string is there, which is rotated in the circular manner. So if rotated in the circular manner, the velocity at the A point will be the perpendicular to that link. It will give velocity of A. So always the velocity is always perpendicular to the link. So by using the similar rule, if it is rotated in the clockwise direction, the velocity of B with respect to A is, we have to draw perpendicular line to this. So this is a A point. So if you are drawing perpendicular to this link, it will give velocity of B with respect to A, because it is perpendicular direction, it is a link, and this is a velocity diagram. Velocity diagram we are using the smaller letter, and for the space diagram we are using the capital letter. So we are getting the velocity of B with respect to A is equal to angular velocity of AB into the radius of AB, because we are knowing V is equal to R omega. Similarly, if C is any point on the link AB, so we have to find out the velocity of C. So at that time we are knowing that velocity of C with respect to A is equal to angular velocity of C with respect to A into AC. So if you take divide both equation, that is the velocity of CA divided by velocity of BA is equal to angular velocity of CA into AC divided by angular velocity of AB into AB. So the angular velocity of CA and AB both are rotated with the angular velocity omega, it will get cancelled. So we are getting AC by AB. So we can easily find out the velocity of CA is equal to velocity of BA into AC by AB. So we are knowing the velocity of BA by using this equation. AC and AB are the distance from this diagram. So we can easily calculate the velocity of CA. So we can locate the velocity of CA on this line. Now, consider any link AB in which VA is known in magnitude as well as in the direction, but VB known in direction only. Then we find the magnitude of VB. Suppose AB is one link. We are knowing the direction of VA as well as the magnitude, and VB is only we are knowing the direction. We have to find out the magnitude of VB. So this is the O pole. From the O pole we are knowing the magnitude as well as the direction of the A, so it will give the VA, and we are knowing the just the direction of the B, so this will give the direction. We have drawn the parallel line to this VB direction, and this is the AB link which is rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. Suppose we have considered it is rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. Now by using this concept, we are knowing that the velocity of any link is perpendicular to that link. So we have draw the perpendicular line. So from the A points, we have draw the perpendicular line like this. So we are getting perpendicular line. So we are getting this B point. So it is nothing but the velocity of B. If you are getting this like this, you are giving the direction, it will give the velocity of B with respect to A. So like this, we can easily find out the velocity of B with respect to A. If I have drawn the direction like this, it will give the velocity of A with respect to B. Okay, these are the basic concept of the relative velocity method. So these are the two references I have taken.